Hello and welcome back to the training. So in this video, I'm going to walk you through the Google Sites. Now I've included the hour and a half training that's step by step, but I wanted to walk you through of exactly what you are going to have to do. So I'm going to walk through the structure and then how you should lay out each of the pages. Before I started my campaign, I literally wrote out how the pages were going to be, and that's what I'm going to share with you. Right? Like the frame goes here, the title goes here, this goes here. Okay. That's what I'm going to lay out for you. Okay. So it's going to be 7 pages total. All right. Now that's not including your blog posts. The blog posts are going to be in subfolders, the parameters. We're going to carry it over. So always use a high volume keyword. So this is how it's going to be set up. You have your 7 pages. If you look over here to the right side, SEO consulting is my main keyword, and then I use my brand name. As you can see up here, that's the name of the site, SEO consulting, Chris Palmer Marketing. The first page is SEO consulting. Whatever keyword you used, flip it around. All right, so that's the second page. Third page is going to be your forms page, then slides, videos, maps, and then my tips page. Okay, that means articles. Now, as you can see inside step 2, inside the PDF, you come in here to properties, you come into advanced, all right, and you want to change the custom path. So name means the name of the page, AKA the title. The path is going to be the URL, okay? So this is the forms page, as you can see here. I'll show you the properties, forms. I made my forms page my contact page, okay? So it's consultation contact. See how I'm using a variation of the keyword? It's my forms page, but this is where they contact. And then I always throw in a variation of a keyword. Always, always use keywords. The next one is slides. If we take a look at this, we go to properties, advanced. This is called my resources because that's what you're sharing, right? SEO consulting resources, okay? Now you can make yours semantic like I am. Let me show you this next one. Properties. This is my videos. I called it SEO consulting videos. I'll show you the next one, which is maps. We'll go to properties, advanced, and this is the maps. So how they can find you, put your directional requests, things along those lines. The next piece is my tips. Now I always use a very large keyword when utilizing my tips page. So I just utilize the same exact primary, so it's SEO consulting, and then I'm going to carry that. Okay, so it's going to be carried inside the parameter. So the next, my first blog post is going to be /blog post number 1. Okay, so just so you know, you carry that with you, so you want a high volume keyword there in place for the blog section. Okay, all right, so that's the structure. Number 2, what I want to go ahead and share with you is how we're going to lay out each of the pages. So let's start with the home page. So it's going to be image up top. I'm just going to lay just like I wrote out here. Look, I want you to see this. I wrote out exactly how I was going to lay out the page. So home page, video and map, title, article, outbound. Okay. So here, I'll just read it off like this. So here's going to be image. Okay. Title. This is going to be a heading tag H1. I have my slide, you put your slides, your homepage has everything that we've created. Okay, these are all embeds. You're gonna embed all of this stuff. This right here is my Calendly asset. Okay, so this is my calendar. Then I embedded a map. I've embedded a sheet right here. This is a my map, okay? And then I have my NAP details with a link back to the site or whatever page you want to rank. I have links, including all links to all of my documents, my forms, my docs, everything that you created inside your stack. Put that at the bottom. And then last but not least is your list of 30, 40, 50, 60, 1,000 words. Put that at the bottom. And then anchor text the most relevant to internal pages on your site or other pages within your Google site. That's completely up to you. So that's the home page. Now let's go to the next page. The next page, which is just a reversal, this is page 2 here, is going to be the header image, okay? Title. Again, you have your H1, a video, my calendar, okay? Subheading, an article, and then you're always going to follow the same format. It's going to be the name, address, phone number with your embeds on it, Okay. So that's how we're going to lay out each of these pages. All right, we'll go to the forms page. So the forms page is, it's going to be the title. Then you do your H1. You literally embed your form. You repeat it in a subheading. And then see, I embedded my map here. And then nap details, all my folders, and then my anchor text. All right, let's go to the next one. So here's my slide. So again, title, it's always the same thing. So slides, it's going to be the title. You put your embed slides, name, address, phone number, links, and then anchor text down at the bottom, okay? Consulting the videos. So again, video, my calendar, I name the page just like with an H1 and an H2, the same thing over and over again. I put my article, which is just repeating the keyword. You don't have to be precise, it's up to you. Name, address, phone number, all of the folders, and then anchor text, okay? Next is my maps. So the maps here is going to contain the video, my calendar. Now I want to put driving directions along with my maps in here. Okay, so as many as you make, put all of your maps in here. Okay, and then follow the format down at the bottom. Name, address, phone number, all of the folders that you created inside a drive, and then put all your anchor text. Okay, and then last but not least is my tips, which is actually the blog. And inside of here, each of the pages that you create, make those subheadings with anchor text going directly over. Okay, so my first article is Best SEO Consultant. On this page, Best SEO Consultant goes over. Now your blog articles need to be made up of all the keywords that you were repeating on all of the other pages. See how I put these keywords down here at the bottom? My blog articles are made up of these keywords because these are all semantically related like we covered, to the main topic. So all my blog content is semantically related, okay? So that's how we're gonna lay these out. We'll talk about stacking up these sites later, but that's gonna wrap up Google Sites, and I'll see you in the next training.